Well, Dad was doing the chore list, and I was like, I really want to hear what I have to do throughout the week. So I went out because I saw the sky, and it was like, oh, it's going to get dark. You know, there might be predators out there for my guinea pigs. So I go out, and there's like a bush beside, not really beside, behind their cage where it was on Sunday. And it was, what's it called? It was like, not as bushy as you think. So it's very visual of where you can see the guinea pigs. So I wasn't like, oh man, where are my babies? And I sort of went out and I tried to grab MaxiBon, but he ran a different direction. And then I heard this scream, and he was constantly screaming, and he was underneath a spade, covering up the snake. So then when I lift the spade up, I saw this snake, and then it just wrapped around his neck. And then I just got this instinct, and I didn't even think through. I was just like, grab the snake, grab the snake. I grabbed it, and then when I was swinging it around, I was like, actually, this is a really smart idea, because like he won't wrap around his neck and kill him. But then, when I was swinging around like 7 times, it let go of my poor guinea pig, and then it grabbed back onto his leg. So then, while I was swinging around, Dad comes out, the family comes out, everyone's still in their pajamas, majority, even I was, and my dad just grabs the snake and sort of like shakes it around, but sort of making the head sort of whack on the ground, so he let go of my guinea pig. The guinea pig runs straight back into the bushes where he was, a bit of a dumb idea for the piggy, and then Dad just throws a snake. Hopefully never to see a snake on our block again.
Wow. So
yeah.
How did you feel? You must have been terrified.
Yes, for the past 2 nights. Well, not really last night, but for the first night, I sort of woke up like 3 times just in a scream. So I like sleeping just nothing, and then I wake up and I'll be like, ah! And then I'd look, and the guinea pigs were actually in the bedroom that I was sleeping in, so they were in my sight, so I was okay. But, yeah, I'm calm now, so I'm okay.
And from what I've heard, your guinea pigs are your prized possessions, your favourite things on earth.
Yeah, very happy to have them. And I'm very glad that it wasn't a poisonous snake, because if it was, sadly, wouldn't have actually grabbed it. I would have just left it. But because we used to have a farm when I was like 6 to 7, and there would be pythons everywhere, 5 meters, 1 meter, all the time. And I was very familiar with their pattern. So when I grabbed the snake, I was like, I'll be fine. I'll be okay. Yeah.
And what did all your friends think when they saw this heroic act?
They basically started laughing, and they were like, haha. Oh, wait, this is real. And then they looked at me and they're like, Rosie, you actually did this. And I was like, yeah. And for the past 2 or 3 days, they've been like asking me. And my mum, as I said, posted it, and they're just constantly, constantly asking me questions.
And were you pretty glad that your guinea pig managed to survive all that?
100%. I really am glad. But from the amount of screaming, my voice is croaky, like, and it sort of hurts sometimes. But getting better, but I'm very happy that they've survived.